Hello everyone. I'm back. I'm doing the format a little differently this time. I felt like the videos were basically just long monologues with shots of paintings, so I'm gonna do it a little this way. I'm coming back with the Umber Berserkers, and I have to say it was a nice way to return because they're pretty straightforward in terms of the paint job. I started off just painting over the face with the base tone I like to use, Bugman's Glow. After that, I basically just went over with all the various browns and different tones I thought would work well. So that would be on the boots and the cloak, the gloves, the handles for the axes. All of those things I wanted to kind of keep varied. Let's not forget, of course, the Stark overcoat. I wanted to keep that theme and those colors kind of the same, so when they're all on the battlefield, you'd get that kind of motif going. I highlighted all the different parts of the bear, and this was to kind of build up the brightness, especially when you're focusing on the miniature's face. You want to be able to draw it in, and the head and the arms were especially good spots to highlight. Now the way I achieved these effects was to build up the brightness by adding in a kind of a lighter mid-yellow tone and maybe a little bit of white. And I found that this kind of gave it a nice shift of color. And when actually applying it, I would fill my brush on the palette, then I would kind of reduce the amount, you know, rub it off as you normally would, and then I carefully ran the brush perpendicular to the surface, and so that way it would kind of build up that nice color slowly, and I would be able to very finely control the amount of brightness. I didn't want it to be overly bright, but still strong enough, so it would show even after the wash, and it would kind of bring that attention and that correct level of tone that would work. Now, when I want to kind of bring up the brightness of the cape, I did like a gentle glaze of having like a fairly lighter brown tone, but using a very thin and small amount to kind of create that color and that kind of a shift I'm looking for. As you finish off with all those basic browns, it's helpful to kind of bring them all back together with that a wash. I use a strong tone because it has kind of a brownish hue to it, so it works well to kind of darken everything. If it's just a pure black tone, it could work, but I prefer the black for armor just because it's a kind of a different beast. And then for the metallics, I actually used non-metallic metal, but because of how few metal pieces there actually were, I think either way could go fine. Like, non-metallic still took a little bit more work, but In general, I would keep the tones a little on the darker side. Now with the non-metallic metal that I use for this model, there's a few techniques to keep in mind if you want to pursue it. First, I dry brushed the chainmail, and this was achieved by putting kind of a darker tone over it, and then filling my brush with a lighter tone, then kind of working out some of that pigment. It didn't have to be a dry brush, but more of like a gentle kind of overcoat that would bring out the texture of the chain. Then I did some blending with the pauldrons to kind of bring the darker in the back kind of to a lighter in the front. Then we had the well, then I had the kind of lower arm guards. Those I added a slightly darker tone to the side closer to the back and a lighter tone to the front to kind of reflect that shift in color when you have two plates that are at different angles, so they'll achieve light differently. Then I used edge highlighting to kind of sharpen those edges and give it some brightness, and the same thing on the axes to kind of bring out the details. After the metallics, then it came to the face. And it's kind of tricky, it kind of isn't, because there's not much area to actually paint. I think all of them have beards and a lot of hair, so there's very little of the actual face to paint. But it's important to make sure you're doing it in the correct order. So I knew that I would get the paint from the that I was using for the face all over the beard, so I wouldn't paint the beard first. After that, I did the lip tone, so usually I just opt for Bugman's Glow because it makes it so they're not really wearing lipstick. It's more of a fleshy lip tone. Then after the skin, I finally painted the beard and did some finishing touches on with mud and blood and scratches, that whole deal. One technique I find especially fun and rewarding is painting hair. So there are only really two steps to it. The first one is to give a good base coat with a natural kind of human hair color in this case. And then I like to highlight it by blending in a brighter yellow and then just kind of gently applying it to kind of bring out the texture of the hairs. For a more salt and pepper look, which I sometimes like to add, I'll just blend in like a good mid gray, maybe lighter gray, and then a white, and make sure the white isn't a pure white, but more of like a brighter gray. And then I just kind of add that as a highlight in just rough locks of hair, and that usually is a very effective way of creating an interesting texture and look. At first, I was like, how am I going to make so many brown tones? But then it's like, you have one or two base browns, you just pick it up and you say, like, I'll just add red. Just add a little maybe a teeny touch of blue. And you're free to kind of shift it how you like. I highly, highly recommend, do not keep these guys neat and perfect. It really, I don't think, goes with the aesthetic of all the ragged clothing. There's stitches. In quite a few of the models, from like the clothes just kind of being repaired and roughly, and maybe they use different pieces of clothing to kind of, and different pieces of hide to kind of build up the layers because of the cold. So, yeah, I think that about brings it to an end. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. I certainly enjoyed painting them, and I'll see you guys soon for Great John.